Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, ConservativeCommandosRadioNetwork.com and CCRN.com for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard.
I think we should make public colleges and universities tuition-free.
Climate change is directly related to the growth of terrorism.
Remove the federal prohibition on marijuana.
Climate change poses immediate risks to our national security.
I did not email any classified material to anyone. There is no classified material. Certainly well aware of the classification requirements.
We have a lot to learn from democratic socialist governments that have existed in countries like Denmark, Sweden, Finland, Norway.
This campaign is about a political revolution to transform this country.
Now more than ever, we need our voice in Washington. Now more than ever, we need Sharon Angle in Washington. Go to runsharonangle.com and help us draft Sharon Angle to run for U.S. Senate.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
And you are listening to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show, WNJC 1360 AM in Philadelphia. It's Monday, the 7th of March. Year of our Lord 2016. I'm Kevin Wade. You recognize my voice. There is a visitor, time traveler from the past on Mondays who's come into the studio. None other than, well, the great guy I used to co-host with for so many shows, J.D. Manier. J.D., welcome to the studios.
It is incredible to be with you again, Kevin. On a beautiful day.
A beautiful day in the Mid-Atlantic. I believe winter is behind us. We had a little dusting about 10 days ago. I hope that's the last of it. And also with you, J.D., is none other than the lovely Christina Lamb. Christina, how are you?
I am doing well. You're right. It is spring.
And someone's tea is ready. I heard a bell go off. And all of us, and I mean everyone in the studio, and there's five of us right now, we're at CPAC last week. J.D., you open up. What was your take on CPAC?
I thought it was pretty awesome, and it was our sixth CPAC, if you count Denver, Colorado, and Chicago, other regional ones. And it was, for us, it was just tremendous. And I'll tell you, the women on the street, Christina was in some televised interviews, and of course, we had some great guests. You and I, we had about four congressmen back-to-back talking about major issues. Kevin, I just really loved it.
And Christina, what was your take?
I think the most important thing I loved was the young people. I loved their enthusiasm. I loved their actual knowledge and understanding of what's going on. I thought it was tremendous.
And Mateo, who is our young studio engineer, was there, and he actually was kind of an old geezer in that crowd, just to give you some sense. Mateo, what did you and your posse find out about CPAC?
I found out that it is a raging conservative bastion of people who love the Constitution, love liberty, and don't really like Donald Trump.
There is a little bit of tension there, Mateo. There was a little bit of tension there between Ted Cruz, the crowd, and the Trumpsters. And, but it's all going to play out. It's all going to play out. They're counting votes all over the country for the next few weeks. I'll tell you, I was impressed again, as you said, with the number of young conservatives who are there, knowledgeable, too. This isn't like your Bernie crowd. And these guys are knowledgeable. Tremendous energy. And I had a chance to see Ben Carson. Actually, I had a chance to see several, but I saw Ben Carson make his kind of, I'll call it the farewell address to CPAC. And the audience loved him. Standing ovation. I mean, probably the most beloved candidate in the campaign cycle now. Standing ovation. And then with one of our other Conservative Commandos Network hosts, I was invited backstage to Ben Carson's final press briefing. Mm. And I was as close to him as I am to you.
Wow.
And his wife, Candy, was standing right next to me. And he carried himself with all that dignity that he has in every step of the way. So we saw his farewell address. We saw the reaction from the crowd, all 15,000. It was something of an historic event here in this year, 2016. What are your takeaways, J.D.?
Well, Ben Carson, you could hear a pin drop. He was asked at the tail end of his speech to describe himself in one word, and then she broadened it to two words, and he thoughtfully looked out to the crowd, and he said, "The children." Now, here's a guy who's operated on 15,000 children, saved so many lives, and yet that's what it's all about. Mateo, it's the next generation that we're trying to bring up, to love our conservative roots, our constitutional Judeo-Christian roots. So I just thought it was awesome.
And following CPAC, over the weekend, we had some very sad news, and we found out that Nancy Reagan passed away.
I know. What an incredible timing of this that was going on, because I noticed in the CPAC there was so much interest and so much talking, even more so than the other CPACs we've been around, about Ronald Reagan. And who would have thought that the very next day that the counterpart to Reagan, and that could be debatable whether she was the first part or the counterpart of Ronald Reagan, that Nancy Reagan had passed away. And it was tremendous for me, because I had a privilege for years to be able to go ahead and be, not to speak with her, but be around her in a very personal way and see what she was like. Again, like Reagan, so warm-hearted and kind. A lot of people would say to me a lot of times, "Oh, she's pretty cold and she's reserved." No, she wasn't. She was quiet. She was shy. But she was watching. She was watching out for her man. That's what she was doing all the time, which was neat. And one of the memories I have of her that probably not too many people would be able to share was, I would see Nancy Reagan when I was a little girl, and she'd be on an exercise bike. And she would be going at it with her best friend that she had for many, many years, and they would be always talking and chattering together like schoolgirls. And I remember, and that is my memory of Nancy Reagan. You know, again, not in the political forefront of that, but just being very real. And of course, you can't forget. And I was with so many social functions with her and private family events. We always know that Ronald Reagan had such that twinkle in his eye. She had that twinkle that came in anytime he got around her. And that was the neatest thing. And that's what I'm going to remember about that.
Well, I mean, and she is beloved around the country among everyone who has an open heart and a clear conscience. And as you said when you first began your remarks, maybe there's no Ronald Reagan that we understand as Ronald Reagan without you know, a woman who was known as Nancy Davis at first and then later Nancy Reagan, because I think that she gave him the kind of the focus and the direction.
Yeah,
he had the raw talent and the natural ability to communicate and an understanding of people and principles.
Right.
But he may not have gotten to the church on time, so to speak, without Nancy Reagan.
Well, and I believe, and you, honey, you talk about this, but she protected him.
And she did. There was no question about it. And she was very devout in that and very faithful in that. And coming from even the environment that he came out of, you know, that is something far, you know, between dealing with Hollywood and everything. But she was, though she was a little tiny woman, and she, you know, she was all in stature, she was mighty in strength and mighty in heart and character in so many ways. And that was, to me, was tremendous.
We have a pretty good lineup of guests today. Do you want to lead us through, J.D.?
Well, I get the privilege of interviewing Ben Collins, a decorated U.S. Army Special Fortress veteran and a Green Beret. We get to talk about national defense and security, and that's going to be a lot of fun. Looking forward to that. That's one we've been trying to bring about, and so we're blessed today to have Ben Collins at 3:35. Then at 4:05, we have a local candidate here in New Jersey, the U.S. House Rep candidate, 1st District, and it's Mr. Bob Patterson. He wants to return us to policies that favor Main Street over Wall Street, and he's a great conservative, and I want to pass on then Kevin, because I think you're going to interview.
Yeah, then at 4:35, we have John Henry Weston. He's co-founder and editor-in-chief of LifeSiteNews.com. And he's spoken at conferences all over the place and appeared on radio and television throughout the New World and the Old about the issue of life. And he's going to talk about this UN rights chief apparently using this unfortunate virus Zika, Z-I-K-A, as a calling card to push abortion. So that's John Henry Weston talking about the proper role for the UN in the lives of people around the world. So we have this week, I think we have a couple more debates and caucuses coming up. You on top of that?
Well, at CPAC, I said this is what we need to do for that next GOP debate. It's kind of like a game show where you have two lifelines. We're going to just say you can have at maximum just two ad hominem attack statements, and if you go on the third, we're going to pull you out. We're going to hit the buzzer, and I really think Rince Priebus, they do need to reframe what they're doing so people can hear more about issues. What say you, Kevin?
Well, I mean, the debate schedule was put together by the RNC a long time ago, and they tried to do it in a way that was fair to Republicans, candidates, and also would get some interest from the broadcasters because they pay the bills. And the quality of the questions are going to be based on, you know, the people who are brought in to be the moderators. And I think Fox News has done a pretty good job. The fact that it takes on a carnival atmosphere doesn't have anything to do with the networks. It has something to do with how some of the candidates conduct themselves. But that's for the people to see and decide. There were some election results over the weekend, and Ted Cruz was coming up strong. In terms of delegates earned on Saturday, he led the pack. And he had a good win in Kansas, and then he had a win in Maine, which would not be considered Cruz country. So, of course, Trump won in Louisiana and Kentucky, but it was tighter than people were projecting a week earlier. So now we're coming up into, Michigan tomorrow, and we'll see how close that is between Donald Trump and Ted Cruz. And with that, we'll let our listeners ponder on that. That's tomorrow night. Big open primary in the Wolverine state of Wisconsin. I want to remind our listeners, we are coming to you live from the Conservative Commandos Radio Network Studios, WNJC 1360, our flagship station in Philadelphia. And around the world on the internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, and AM, FM 24/7. I'm Kevin Wade. I'm joined in the studio by J.D. Manier. Stay with us. We'll be back in about 6 minutes. Let me do it.
The Conservative Commandos radio show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos radio network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos radio network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Vyden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
I think we should make public colleges and universities tuition-free.
Climate change is directly related to the growth of terrorism.
Remove the federal prohibition on marijuana.
Climate change poses immediate risks to our national security.
I did not email any classified material to anyone. There is no classified material. Certainly well aware of the classification requirements.
We have a lot to learn from democratic socialist governments that have existed in countries like Denmark, Sweden, Finland, Norway.
This campaign is about a political revolution to transform this country.
You know?
Now more than ever, we need our voice in Washington. Now more than ever, we need Sharon Angle in Washington. Go to runsharonangle.com and help us draft Sharon Angle to run for U.S. Senate.
You can call the Conservative Commandos radio show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando radio show.
Thank you, Colonel West. You are listening to the Conservative Commandos radio network. If you'd like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our website, ccrsnetwork.com. and ccrshow.com. For mornings at 9 a.m., log on to Leading Edge Radio. At 1 p.m., log on to roarradio.net. That's R-O-A-R, radio.net. And at 9 p.m., log on to highplainsdailynews.com. And you can listen to Conservative Commandos from any phone by calling 832-999-1199. That's 832-999-1199. I'm Kevin Wade, joined in the studio by the voice from the past, none other than Monday's J.D., formerly Monday's J.D. Manier, and the lovely Christina.
Well, you know, our next guest, Kevin, is Ben Collins. He's a decorated U.S. Army Special Forces veteran, a Green Beret.
I know he is, but he's not here yet. He's still packing his chute.
He's jumping the gun.
He's still packing his chute, J.D. Now, he'll jump in here in about 7.5 minutes.
That's why I'm not on Mondays anymore.
Get ready on the microphone there. So, we have a backup ready just in case, folks. It is Monday. And at this time, even though JD doesn't remember, at this time I usually do a commentary. So you can turn your radios off now if you'd like, because I'm about to start and it's going to run about 6 minutes. I call it political revolution. The American Revolution did not appear out of nothingness. The Battle of Bunker Hill in Boston wasn't a chance meeting between American settlers and the British Redcoats. The Continental Congress in 1776 in Philadelphia wasn't a commerce convention that suddenly took a direction into self-government. The revolution sprang from 20 years of friction, which led to irritation that, in time, caused inflammation, followed by failed remedies, and finally led to open hostility and bitter warfare. It did not arise out of a vacuum and for no reason. Today, there is a political revolution taking place. It, too, does not arise from a vacuum and for no reason. It takes its form because of friction, irritation, and failed remedies. The two sides in today's conflict are not American settlers, but American citizens. And not redcoats, but Washington's governing class. This modern revolution is not isolated to one political viewpoint. This is a national uprising and includes citizens of each major party and all viewpoints. It spans from Maine to Louisiana and Georgia to Minnesota. Three of the four remaining and prominent candidates for president each represent a constituency among the rebels. Senator Ted Cruz represents those that seek to return to a land of true values, faith, freedom, and constitutional lawful governance. Businessman Donald Trump represents those who seek to return to safety from imported dangers, dangers to our life, and dangers to our jobs and prosperity. Senator Bernie Sanders seeks to return to an enforced fair play for the middle class by a heavy dose of Big Brother by big government. And Hillary Clinton simply schemes to return to the White House by hook or by crook. Apart from Hillary Clinton, the others are riding a popular wave to purge Washington and the ruling class and their donor enablers of their corrupting power and influence. People are demanding a bold, new, fresh start in their own lives and in the life of the country. They're ready to accept the hazard of throwing the good baby out with the bad bathwater. They see it is better to risk walking with the devil they don't know than wasting one more day with the old devils in Washington they now do know. As with our original American Revolution, the end of this political revolt will be different than imagined here at the beginning. Who will prove to be our 21st century George Washington, who might become a reviled traitor to the cause, the modern Benedict Arnold? Revolutions are not football pep rallies. Do not enter into rebellion lightly, or for even the success we seek has a sacrifice that is now unseen. If we're going to pass an America down to our children, shiny penny new, then let us, as citizens, go ahead with courage and faith. Let us choose well our leaders, for we need leaders with courage enough and faith enough to see the task through to a future secure, safe, united, and prosperous for all. I'm Kevin Wade. That's the way I see it, J.D.
Boy, was that well put. Because that Declaration of Independence enumerated all the things the British monarch had done to injure...
Over a 20-year period.
Yes. And we have come to that point again.
But not with bullets, with ballots. And there's a great bubbling up and a disorder, and I think things will line out between now and November. And I believe we'll be on a new road, and hopefully we have people good enough to see us through the road. I know we can't stay where we are now. And the surprising thing is people all over the country... I mean, really, from all these different backgrounds, no, we can't stay where we are now.
Well, I think it's significant, too, that the vision is being voted on each state, where the GOP has multiple visions, but yet it's a forward path that people are signing on to in record numbers in turnout. You look at Hillary and Bernie, they're lackluster.
They had record numbers in Maine, Democrat caucus yesterday.
That's the first time. Okay.
Record. And then in Virginia, on the Republican side, they had four times as many people come out to vote. Not 14% more. Not 40. Four times. I mean, amazing. And anyone who thinks it's business as usual going out into the future is absolutely crazy, which is why Hillary Clinton should really be, you know, looking forward to a long retirement because she represents Washington going back to the 1970s. She was in Washington before Ronald Reagan was in Washington.
Well, she was, and she tried to help prosecute Nixon, and then they kicked her off because of the cheating that she was doing. That's how she really got started.
Questionable conduct, even in the earliest days of her career. So she doesn't represent change. She represents more of the same. And in fact, it's I can't even say the same. More of the worst that we've had to endure is what she represents. And I think we're going to go into a break. If we're listening, you are listening, we're speaking, to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, WNJC 1360 AM, our flagship station in Philadelphia. And around the world on the Internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, and AM/FM. 24/7. They all end in .com. I'm Kevin Wade. J.D. Manier is here. You stay with us. We'll be back in about 5 minutes.
Playing the music on the Your Music Matters Morning Show. He is also an experienced mortgage loan officer working for U.S. Mortgage Corporation and assists homeowners navigate the reverse mortgage process. If you are finding yourself asking questions whether or not you set aside enough for retirement, Paul can sit down with you, your family, and your financial advisor and discuss how a reverse mortgage may be a valuable resource for your retirement plan. You will be responsible for paying your taxes and insurance, and the reverse mortgage can help with this and other expenses, such as home health care or other untimely bills. Put Paul's 20-plus years of experience to work for you, as choosing the right option for your situation can be critical. Call Paul at U.S. Mortgage Corporation at 877-213-9977. That's 877-213-9977. Or go to seniormatters.info for more information. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is a licensed mortgage banker in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Delaware, and an equal housing lender. NMLS number 3901. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is located at 201 Old Country Road, Suite 140, Melville, New York, 11747. This advertisement applies to first lien mortgages. Paul E. Dilks, NMLS, is 485904.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Boswell Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Biden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology? To be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time, without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCS for automation.com. That's PCS, the number 4, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, conservativecommandosradionetwork.com and ccrn.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard.
I think we should make public colleges and universities tuition-free.
Climate change is directly related to the growth of terrorism.
Remove the federal prohibition on marijuana.
Climate change poses immediate risks to our national security.
I did not email any classified material to anyone. There is no classified material. Certainly well aware of the classification requirements.
We have a lot to learn from democratic socialist governments that have existed in countries like Denmark, Sweden, Finland, Norway.
This campaign is about a political revolution to transform this country.
You know?
Now more than ever, we need our voice in Washington. Now more than ever, we need Sharon Angle in Washington. Go to runsharonangle.com and help us draft Sharon Angle to run for U.S. Senate.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Thank you, Colonel West. You're now listening to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. I'm Kevin Wade. In the studio with me is J.D. Manier, and you're listening to WNJC. If that's your rebroadcast, listen, go to our websites, ccrsnetwork.com, ccrshow.com, or mornings at 9 a.m., log on to Leading Edge Radio Network, or at 1 p.m., log on to roarradio.net, roarradio.net, and at 9 p.m., log on to highplainsdailynews.com. And you can listen to the Conservative Commandos from any telephone on planet Earth by calling 832-999-1199. Some toll charges might apply depending upon where you call from. But the board is green. The weather is good. J.D., I'm so happy to see you at a microphone right across the table from me. And let's kick it off with our first great guest.
Well, Ben Collins is a decorated U.S. Army Special Forces veteran. He's a Green Beret who completed multiple combat rotations in support of the global war on terrorism. Ben is a regular guest on Fox News, as well as frequent radio shows from Arizona to New York City and the BBC World Service. Ben is most often asked to comment on fight against ISIS, terrorism, and national security issues. And welcome back to the Conservative Commando Radio Show, Ben.
Hi, guys. How are you today?
Doing really well. Just right off the bat, let's talk about why we can win battles, but we're not winning the wars anymore.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think that's something that we've seen, unfortunately, you know, in the last, I'd say the last, you know, the last years of Bush and certainly the entirety of Obama's administration. And to be honest, I think it stems from the fact that, you know, when you've got no clear guidance, there's no clear mission, right? If you don't actually know what it is you're trying to achieve, one, and two, that you have the full support of kind of the, you know, certainly your leadership behind you, I think people start to become pretty risk averse. They start getting careerist, and that's a hard thing to introduce to the battlefield. And in that sense, I think that you know, that's where we start to see the unfortunate reality where people are you know, listening to the lawyers before they're listening to the warriors, and you start to see things like you know, rules of engagement get tightened up and close air support gets restricted. You know, that's certainly been what we've seen in Afghanistan. We've seen it for years. We saw it in Iraq. And we see it now in the fight against ISIS. I think I'm sure everybody remembers recently hearing the stories that, you know, 75% of the sorties that were coming back from their bombing runs in Syria or Iraq against ISIS were coming back without actually having dropped their ordnance. And that was predominantly a political decision. So I think that's at the heart of it.
Political correctness in the Department of Defense. How quickly can we vanquish that come this next election cycle? How quickly can that go?
Well, look, unfortunately, I don't think, you know, one's a political reality, and I think one's a, you know, one's a just a reality of what's occurring on these battlefields. I think that, you know, depending on who the president is, that would be certainly be a first start. I mean, it obviously all starts at the top. But, you know, if I'm going to be, you know, frank, I think it's going to take years for that to kind of get flushed out of the system. It's not something that can change overnight. And especially in that, you know, at the heart of this thing, it's you've got, you know, realities on the ground in Afghanistan, certainly, where, you know, because we pulled back and because we just haven't really been engaged and understood what it was that we were trying to accomplish there, you know, Afghanistan's just fallen apart. ISIS has found some footing on the battlefield. The Taliban now own more territory than they did post, you know, our successes in the invasion. You know, so that's a huge problem. So I think the first step is figuring out, you know, is fixing what's occurring within the military domain. You know, and then the second one is actually figuring out what it is that you know, that we actually you know, want to accomplish over there. You know, what's feasible? What do the American people want? And a lot of that, I think, you know, to be honest, I think Congress needs to actually start doing their constitutional duty and actually managing the military in the right way.
How can we do that better? What's the first step in your opinion?
Well, I think that you know, obviously the American people are tired of you know, I mean, this is the longest, you know, running war, right? 14 years in Afghanistan and counting, in terms of cost and you know, American, you know, blood of heroes. I think that you know, part of it is the fact that the verbiage, right? I mean, we have a president that won't even say, you know, Islamic terrorism or Islamic fundamentalist. So we can't even name the enemy. So if we can't name the enemy, then we can't start to understand the enemy. And if we don't understand the enemy, then we're not going to be able to put together a plan to defeat it. And I think that we've almost gotten to a point where a lot of the American public has almost been allowed to kind of distance themselves. And Congress especially, you know, the way, you know, Congress, we haven't declared war since 1941. I mean, the end of, you know, World War II, essentially. You know, they've only declared war five times. And every time since then, it's been a, you know, authorization use of military force, what they call, you know, AUMF. You know, and actually just recently, unfortunately, because the fact that he was a veteran and the fact that he's a Republican, but not my kind of Republican. Lindsey Graham just put forward a new bill that essentially was, you know, it was trying to give the president basically carte blanche to fight war. You know, no geographical boundaries, no time boundaries, you know, none of that. And so while I think we definitely need to start cranking up on the way that we're fighting this, just there's, you know, constitutionally there's a part of me that just abhors the idea of just giving all this, you know, all the power into the executive. I mean, that's one of the reasons we put together, that's one of the reasons why the Constitution was written as it was. So I think if Congress starts to get more engaged, you know, then the American people can start to get more engaged. You know, look, the tactics of fighting these battles, you know, like you said at the very beginning, you know, we win battles. Battles are easy. You know, right? That's the easier thing. We've gotten very good as a country at kicking doors in. We know how to do that. That's not the hard part. You know, the hard part is the strategic part. And I think if we learned anything, or hopefully learned anything, certainly about our experiences in Afghanistan and Iraq, it's that, you know, this concept of nation building and utilizing soldiers to try to rebuild a country that's stuck in the, you know, 7th century is just not a feasible option. So what's the plan, Mr. President? What's the plan, Congress, right? What's the plan, Mr. Joint Chiefs? So I know I just gave you a that's a huge place to start, but I think the American people need to really start standing up and demanding that their congressmen actually start to participate in a way that honors our soldiers.
Hey, Ben, this is Kevin Wade. We're coming up onto a break. Would you stay with us so we can pick up this conversation on the other side?
Absolutely.
And, Ben, I want you to think what victory looks like. Let's talk about what victory looks like. What are we trying to actually leave behind when we leave it behind the next time around? So you think about that. We're going into a break right now. You are listening to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, broadcasting from our flagship station in Philadelphia and around the world on the Internet with American Patriots, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, and AM/FM 24/7. TheAllInIn.com. My name ends in Wade. JD, his name ends in Manier. You stay with us. We'll be back in 4 minutes and 8.76 seconds.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the Internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Vine of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
I think we should make public colleges and universities tuition-free.
Climate change is directly related to the growth of terrorism.
Remove the federal prohibition on marijuana.
Climate change poses immediate risks to our national security.
I did not email any classified material to anyone. There is no classified material. Certainly well aware of the classification requirements.
We have a lot to learn from democratic socialist governments that have existed in countries like Denmark, Sweden, Finland, Norway.
This campaign is about a political revolution to transform this country.
You know?
Now more than ever, we need our voice in Washington. Now more than ever, we need Sharon Angle in Washington. Go to runsharonangle.com and help us draft Sharon Angle to run for U.S. Senate.
You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Hey, you are listening to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show, and Colonel Alan West had his tour in the sandbox, and I believe you served his troops well. If you'd like to rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our website, ccrsnetwork.com and ccrshow.com, or mornings at 9 a.m., log on to Leading Edge Radio Network, or at 1 p.m., log on to roarradio.net, roarradio.net. And 1 p.m., log on, we did that. 9 p.m., log on to High Plains Daily News. And you can listen to the Conservative Commandos from any phone by calling 832-999-1199. Ben Collins was asked during the break to take a thought about what victory looks like. And, J.D., pick it up.
Yeah, let's get that laid out. We talked prior to the break, and during the break, it needs to be in the hands of the generals to determine when we've won and report back to not the politicians to have them spin it, but let the generals say when it's all finished. What do you say?
Yeah, well, look, I certainly agree with that. I mean, there's, I would say, you know, the war is won, you know, not, at least in my, from my perspective, it's, you know, I'd rather people start listening to the sergeants, right? I mean, that's the reality here. You know, however, the management, at least, of the military is a constitutional responsibility of Congress. And I think that you know, if Congress has a lever, right, if they've got any leverage, you know, they've got it fiscally. And I think that Congress should be standing, I think, in that gap between the White House and the Pentagon and ensuring that, you know, that from a strategic level, at least, that plans put together are coherent. Because we just haven't had anything coherent, you know, for well over a decade. So I certainly agree with that. You know, they need to start listening to the military professionals. This president, President Obama, has you know, all but ignored, you know, most of the advice that's coming from the Pentagon. You know, however, I think if there's going to be a way to influence that, you know, that's got to come from the American people, and that's got to come through, I think, in the guise of their elected representatives in the people's house, because there's only so much that the generals can do, right? I mean, the generals, you know, they can give all the advice and counsel, but, you know, at the end of the day, you know, the president is the commander in chief. In terms of what victory looks like, you know, I think that at times I kind of have been guilty about this as well, in that I think a lot of people in the national security domain, right, it's very easy for us to start going down the slippery slope of you know, look, how can we fix Syria, right, or how can we fix Iraq or fix Afghanistan? And when you ask that question to me, you know, over the break, it kind of forced me to really think about, you know, what is victory? And I think victory to me is at its core that, you know, the American homeland and Americans and our interests are safe, you know, full stop. You know, does that mean that we need to rebuild Afghanistan in some sort of liberal Jeffersonian democracy? Absolutely not. It's never going to happen. Are we going to be able to ever look at the Afghan National Army and they're going to be self-sustaining, that they can conduct operations against the Taliban and against ISIS on their own without U.S. You know, guidance or without U.S. funding? I mean, you know, the reality is Afghanistan just as a whole, never mind their military, but I mean, their entire GDP is practically foreign aid. Certainly their military is foreign aid. So, you know, in my mind, is there a way that we can, you know, defeat the clear and present danger, defeat the threat that's on the battlefield, without us getting involved and ensconced in these large scale efforts to rebuild a society that doesn't want to be rebuilt? To me, I don't think that's success. I think success is how do we protect American citizens.
No, that's a good point. But reconstituting the military, let's talk about that in terms of, you know, projecting what we need to do with a new president, a new Congress. The Heritage Foundation says we're 25% shrunk. Our military, just in the last few years, has really taken a tailspin. Offer some hope. Offer some things that the new Congress and the new president should get on board and start doing right away.
So from big picture to little picture, right? Again, strategic down to tactical. I think that, you know, strategically, what this president has done that is more threatening to me than anything else is that he's removed our ability to have any deterrence, right? I mean, and And that's where the enemy, you know, people like Putin and Assad and this lunatic in North Korea, you know, where they don't act because they know what the U.S. response will be. You know, this president throughout his time has shown that he doesn't want to act, even when he said he will. Right, the famous red line in Syria. You know, how can you declare a red line and then they cross it and you say, well, that's unfortunate, and you don't do anything? You know, South China Sea, they're building islands in the middle of international shipping lanes. You know, the reality is the world did pay attention and our enemies did pay attention, and they saw that we had a president that wouldn't act. And so they started pushing, you know, never mind what Russia has or what Putin and Russia have done in Europe. I mean, they've effectively, well, they have physically circled Turkey through Armenia and Syria with troops and an air base. You know, that's NATO, right? I mean, Putin is doing everything he can to show the world that NATO has no teeth. And so in terms of deterrence, I think that we need to, you know, and that's going to take, again, that's going to take a very long time for us to recover. You know, to the president, I'd say we have to start rebuilding our military in a way that, you know, shows the world that we're serious about our defense, we're serious about our national interests. You know, you mentioned the personnel and the budget cuts. You know, I mean, we have more generals today, okay? We have more generals and admirals, right? The 1, 2, 3, and 4-star billets today than we did during World War II, when we had 10 times the amount of soldiers, okay? I mean, something is not right here, where it's that upside down.
Ben, what happens to good officers when they get that first star and join the general staff? I mean, there's something that happens, and it's not good.
I think it's starting to happen earlier. I think politics gets involved. You know, the guys get a 1-star and they want a 2-star. I think when people, you know, speak out, you know, and we've seen the consequences of that with a great hero like Stan McChrystal. You know, and to me, Stan McChrystal represents, you know, at least probably one of the finest generals we've ever had. And they removed him because there was a public spat. Now I get it. It was a disrespectful public thing to the president. But you know, my fear is that when that, you know, all the way down to the troop level, I mean, because of budget cuts, and because of Congress's inaction, literally they're having equipment, you know, they can't equip fully, right? There's a news story today that talks about SEALs complaining that they don't have enough rifles, for every SEAL. Right, that when there's a deploying unit, that they essentially, you know, one team gives that team, you know, all the equipment that they need. You know, that's absurd. Never mind the training costs. I mean, people can't train like they fight, and that's a real problem. So, you know, to the new president, to Congress, I'd say, look, we have to start rebuilding this military to be, you know, again, the greatest military that exists. And I've heard the counter argument. Right, the counter argument is, yeah, well, you know, the U.S. spends, you know, more than the top 5 or 6 countries combined on their budget.
Ben, let me interrupt there. Ben, let me interrupt. Here's the proper rebuttal, because I hear it come up again and again and again. We also spend more on health care than the next 3 or 4. We also spend more on health, on public education the next 3 or 4. This is an expensive place to do things, and we like to do things right. Frankly, we spend more money on lipstick than the next 3 countries combined. So whenever anyone brings this up, that we have some disproportionate or inappropriate amount assigned for defense needs, just put the lipstick argument up. Even the liberals eventually get it.
That's a great point. And that is a very, you know, Cold War mentality, right? Of you know, how many number of tanks do we have? You know, and I think that we're, you know, anybody that can say, look, we're not going to have another large ground war, right, a la Europe. Well, then I'll point to Turkey, right? And I think a lot of people, myself included, when Turkey shot down, you know, that Russian plane, you know, all I could think about was, up here comes Article 5 of NATO, right? You know, I think if we learned anything is we can't predict the future, and we have to be ready for large-scale wars or multiple small-scale wars. You know, and going back to your question coming out of the break in terms of what victory looks like, look, we need a plan. You know, I mean, the reality is that the global jihadist threat is real, and it's going to take, you know, years, right, maybe a generation to defeat. And my concern there is, look, if you give the generals and the colonels down to the sergeants, if you give them a plan, they will execute it, okay? But But if you look at our electoral cycle, I mean, just look what's happening right now. You know, I always go back to the Cold War, right? I mean, the Cold War was a strategy that came out of, you know, essentially the domino theory and trying to defeat communism and to defeat Russia. And that was a strategic plan that carried us through seven presidents, you know, four Republicans and three Democrats. Now, they all put their own operational, you know, pieces in place and changes left or right. But overall, that was a strategic plan that lasted seven presidencies. And it used our military, our diplomatic efforts, our intelligence efforts, our economic efforts.
You're right on, Ben. We're coming up on a hard break. I have to point out, though, those top nations, they lie. The Duma, China, Russia, Iran, they lie about what they're really spending, kind of like Hitler. So that's where a big problem is, too.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Ben, quick website, something for our listeners to follow.
Well, sure. Look, I've got nothing extravagant. I'm kind of new to the media side, but the bencollins.media, I post op-eds that I write and the things that I do on Fox. That's a place to, that's at least a place to go as I start to figure this whole thing out that you guys have
been. Ben, the guy who owns the microphone just said you do a pretty darn good job for being new at it. I'll tell you what, you are invited back here anytime you want. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks, guys.
You are listening to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network Studios. If you'd like to hear our rebroadcast, now let's do it this way. Around the world, you can hear us around the world, all kinds of places. Lots of internet sites, and we've got to move on to the next guest. I'm Kevin Wade. J.D. Manier is here. The boss is here, and the boss's boss, so to speak, is here. Thanks for being with us. We'll be back in 6 minutes.
Playing the music on the Your Music Matters Morning Show. He is also an experienced mortgage loan officer working for U.S. Mortgage Corporation and assists homeowners navigate the reverse mortgage process. If you are finding yourself asking questions whether or not you set aside enough for retirement, Paul can sit down with you, your family, and your financial advisor and discuss how a reverse mortgage may be a valuable resource for your retirement plan. You will be responsible for paying your taxes and insurance, and the reverse mortgage can help with this and other expenses, such as home health care or other untimely bills. Put Paul's 20-plus years of experience to work for you, as choosing the right option for your situation can be critical. Call Paul at U.S. Mortgage Corporation at 877-213-9977. That's 877-213-9977. Or go to seniormatters.info for more information. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is a licensed mortgage banker in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Delaware, and an equal housing lender. NMLS number 3901. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is located at 201 Old Country Road, Suite 140, Melville, New York, 11747. This advertisement applies to first lien mortgages. Paul E. Dilks, NMLS, is 485904.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Biden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology? To be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCS for automation.com. That's PCS, the number four, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, ConservativeCommandosRadioNetwork.com and CCRN.com for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard.
I think we should make public colleges and universities tuition-free.
Climate change is directly related to the growth of terrorism.
Remove the federal prohibition on marijuana.
Climate change poses immediate risks to our national security.
I did not email any classified material to anyone. There is no classified material. Certainly well aware of the classification requirements.
We have a lot to learn from democratic socialist governments that have existed in countries like Denmark, Sweden, Finland, Norway.
This campaign is about a political revolution to transform this country.
You know?
Now more than ever, we need our voice in Washington. Now more than ever, we need Sharon Angle in Washington. Go to runsharonangle.com and help us draft Sharon Angle to run for U.S. Senate.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Hey, thanks for staying with us. If you'd like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our website, ccrsnetwork.com and ccrshow.com, or mornings at 9 a.m., log on to Leading Edge Radio Network, or at 1 p.m., log on to roarradio.net. And at 9 p.m., log on to highplainsdailynews.com. And you can listen to the Conservative Commandos from any telephone on planet Earth by calling 832-999-1199. That's 832-999-1199. J.D., it's a lot of fun working with you again here on Mondays.
Oh, I think so, too.
And I'll tell you, I appreciate you being here so much. Why don't you do two interviews in a row? Tell us who the next guest is.
Well, Bob Patterson is a candidate for the Republican nomination to run for Congress from New Jersey's 1st Congressional District. He believes we need to return to policies that favor Main Street over Wall Street. Most recently, Bob worked as a contributor to the Philadelphia Inquirer and as vice president for government relations at the U.S. Business Industrial Council, USBIC. That's an organization committed to strengthening U.S. manufacturing and opposing Congress's globalist corporate trade agenda. Welcome back to the Conservative Commando Radio Show, or maybe for the first time, but welcome, Bob.
J.D., thank you. I think I've been on the Conservative Commandos program one time for the U.S. Business and Industry Council when we talked about the Fast Track Authority last June when Congress was voting on that, giving Obama Fast Track Authority. But thank you, J.D., for having me on your program today about my run for Congress.
Well, real quickly, how can we make South Jersey great again?
Well, the way we can make South Jersey great again is by bringing modern manufacturing industries back to the region and creating tens of thousands of secure, high-wage jobs with generous benefits for the people of South Jersey. We also have to protect the neglected middle-income workers of the region against the onslaught of foreign workers and illegals squeezing their livelihoods. And also, we have to keep America safe and strong from massive global threats, especially Islamic terrorism. Those are the three ways I'm planning to make South Jersey great again.
Can we revive the American dream?
Absolutely, we can revive the American dream. The dream has been lost over the last 25 years, especially here in New Jersey. New Jersey has lost 300,000 high-wage manufacturing jobs since 1990. That's 1,000 jobs every single month for 25 years. And that doesn't count when you add the multiplier effect of, I don't have the exact number, but there's scores of other jobs that are related to manufacturing that were lost out as well. We cannot sustain, no country, no state, no region can sustain itself when we're losing that kind of manufacturing capability and basically outsourcing much of our production. You know, we're outsourcing whole lines of production to China, to Japan, and to Mexico. That has no way to build a country or a superpower. We've got to control our borders. We've got to control our own economy to be a country.
Well, that's that great sucking sound. And,
exactly.
And what's some of your plans? I'm running for Congress, too, back in Indianapolis in the Midwest. And what are some of the good ideas that we need to bring forth in Washington?
Well, the ideas I'm pushing for start with reviving manufacturing or defense-related manufacturing sectors. You can't be a second-to-none defense. We've got to protect America against foreign threats. Our Navy has been decimated. We need a next generation missile defense system, and so I would begin with reviving those sectors that are related to defense. If we have a large enough Navy buildup, if we push for a 400 or 425 ship Navy, there's a possibility we could bring shipbuilding back to Camden, New Jersey. Camden used to be the home of the old New York Shipbuilding Corporation. At that time was the largest private sector shipbuilding yard in the world. And if we have a large enough Navy buildup, we could bring shipbuilding back to Camden, create at least 10,000 new jobs. If we push for a second-generation missile defense system, we ought to be giving contracts to Lockheed Martin and Boeing. Both of them have operations in South Jersey, and we need to give them contracts to build that next-generation missile defense system. I've also called for a Robert Moses-like transportation infrastructure for South Jersey, including a twin span of the Walt Whitman Bridge to separate truck and car traffic, a great separation that would go all the way down to the Atlantic City Expressway. I've called for making 295 at least an 8-lane freeway from I-42 up to Route 73. I've called for a new PATCO a tunnel under the Delaware for the PATCO trains, and another line of PATCO down to Glasper. Not a light rail, but a PATCO line that would go from Glasper all the way back into Center City to revive that sector. There's a corridor there waiting for development. And with Rowan University down there in Glassboro, that's the perfect place to put another PATCO high-speed line.
Well, let me back you up on that. You know, Lincoln called for big ideas, and the Republican Party does need big ideas. But
these
I just
big
wanna,
ideas, I hope you agree.
Oh, well, we need those big ideas, and I thank you. But I want to back you up to that missile defense system.
Yes.
North Korea, what the Obama administration is talking about, the capabilities of North Korea is way lowballed. And they have the capability of coming all over to the Midwest. They can go any part of the United States with their missiles. And don't forget Scuds with terrorist organizations, Iran. So I'm in there in lockstep with you on missile defense system. We got to protect our electric grid. You talked about infrastructure. Let's move forward then. Let's talk a little bit about, though, this. You talk about health care. What's your ideas?
On my ideas on health care?
Yes.
Well, I technically support, I do support a universal health system. And I'm for making sure that all American citizens, I'm not talking about illegals, but all American citizens have access to basic care. The Obamacare has got some problems with it. I think it was right in the sense that it sought for universal care. The execution of Obamacare has been a disaster. And so I'm for finding ways to reduce the cost of health care, but while at the same time providing universal care for American citizens, not illegals.
Now, how would you do that? Are you talking about expanding dramatically Medicaid, or what route are you thinking about there?
A lot of this has to be talked about. I haven't really mapped out. I mean, I've written for the Philadelphia Inquirer, and a couple years ago, I laid out what I called a utility plan for health care. That didn't get any traction. But I got to really think through how exactly we would do this. But I do support a universal system that covers American citizens and also provides some type of regulation of routine medical care. You know, in the old days, we let Ma Bell build the best telephone system in the world. And Ma Bell provided cheap, universal service throughout the whole country. We regulated as a monopoly. We gave them monopoly status, and we allowed them to, you know, operate basic phone service. And I think that those same principles of utility capitalism could be applied to the healthcare market today.
Hey, I like your priorities, though. National defense
and
getting
that's
jobs.
The same thing.
Yes.
Here's the other thing about healthcare we got to do. That's probably even more important than we spend all this time talking about health care, where the real concerns of Americans are health itself. And the Philly South Jersey region is a center of medical research. We need to turn this region into a Jack Kemp enterprise zone where we have fast track before FDA approval and also getting the trial lawyers out of the way to, you know, pursue medical cures for Alzheimer's, for cancer, find cures, not simply, we don't want to just treat people for conditions. We want to find cures because it's a lot cheaper to beat than to treat. So in many of my pieces in the Philadelphia Inquirer over the last several years, I've talked about pushing for a moonshot where we really push for medical cures and fighting disease that in the long term will save us billions of dollars in healthcare spending.
Hey, we're coming up on a hard break. Can you stay with us, though, Bob, for the next section?
JD, absolutely.
Well, we're coming.
Listening to WNJC 1360 AM. Conservative Commandos Radio. Here in the flagship station in Philadelphia and around the world on the internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, Talk Stream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeart Radio, and AM FM 24/7. I'm Kevin Wade. I'm co-host today, and I'm actually dumbstruck at the moment, which was why I was delayed in coming into the break. But I'm ready to go now. You stay with us. We'll be back in about 3 minutes and 50 seconds.
I really don't care. That's my prerogative. They say I'm nasty, but I...
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Vyden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
I think we should make public colleges and universities tuition-free.
Climate change is directly related to the growth of terrorism.
Remove the federal prohibition on marijuana.
Climate change poses immediate risks to our national security.
I did not email any classified material to anyone. There is no classified material. Certainly well aware of the classification requirements.
We have a lot to learn from democratic socialist governments that have existed in countries like Denmark, Sweden, Finland, Norway.
This campaign is about a political revolution to transform this country.
Now more than ever, we need our voice in Washington. Now more than ever, we need Sharon Engel in Washington. Go to runsharonengel.com and help us draft Sharon Engel to run for U.S. Senate.
You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Colonel West, we wish you were still in Congress, our friend. If you'd like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our website, ccrsnetwork.com and ccrshow.com. Or mornings at 9 a.m., log on to Leading Edge Radio Network. Or at 1 p.m., log on to RoarRadio.net. And at 9 p.m., log on to High Plains Daily News. And you can listen to the Conservative Commandos from any telephone on planet Earth by calling 832-999-1199. Check your service supplier in case some toll charges apply. I'm Kevin Wade. It is Monday, the first Monday in March. Am I right about that? Yes, I think I am. And I'm pleased to be in the studio with J.D. Manier. We've done so many shows together in the past, and now it's a matter of circumstance. We're sitting here today, and I'm enjoying it. So I'm just listening in. You've got a great interview going here, and pick it up, please.
Hey, Bob, let's...
J.D., good to have you back, or good to be back.
Yes, Bob Patterson, 1st District, New Jersey, U.S. House Rep candidate. A conservative, and to prove that conservatism a little more, let's talk about the support of Israel.
Absolutely. Israel is our only ally, really, over there in the Middle East. It's our first ally over there, and we've got to protect Israel against the Islamic crazies over there. That's another reason why we got to do missile defense, because we want the stuff we do here, we share with Israel. So if we can perfect our missile defense system, put up a second 21st century missile defense system that protects, I guess you had just said, not just the coast, but the Midwest from North Korea or from Iran. Iran's going to have a nuclear weapon with or without this crazy deal of Obama's. We need to build our defenses, share that with Israel, and protect Israel, our first ally, our first of all allies in the Middle East.
Well, I like the way you talk about the economy, and let's touch on the subject of regulations, though.
Yes.
The Competitive Enterprise Institute points out that last year we spent about $1.88 trillion as Americans just to pay for embedded regulations. That's $15,000 per household. Let's talk about us going to Washington and cutting the fat and cutting the regulations.
got to find a way. These regulations have been with us going back to the 70s. A lot of this stuff, too, is all intended not really to improve product safety or protect individuals, but they're designed to basically slow down the economy. And I'm thinking about some of the red tape that's been put on all building projects, all infrastructure projects, on the basis that we have to protect the environment. Now, all Republicans, all conservatives are for clean air and clean water, but some of this red tape where they tie up projects for years. Every region of the country has got bridges, got highways, tunnels to be built, and they're just tied up in court. Not because these projects are going to cause a problem on the environment, but they want to protect some endangered species, as if the endangered species is more important than American jobs and the American economy. So we've got to do away with a lot of these. We got to find a way to fast track these infrastructure projects so that the economy can grow and that we can create jobs for our people.
How about energy independence? Talk a little
definitely
bit about that.
We need energy independence, and why we should not have lifted that oil export embargo. We had a ban on oil exports that Congress lifted last December. We've got to do refining of oil here, not send it overseas to be refined somewhere else. That doesn't help energy independence. 95% of our oil and gas reserves under federal lands and waters has not been tapped. That's a gold mine of energy, and cheap energy at that, that we ought to be tapping to ensure we have cheap and abundant energy for our economy and for our people.
Hey, let's talk about reforming tax and trade laws. Go ahead.
The big danger is our trade laws have just handicapped the country since NAFTA, since first most favored nation status to China. All these trade deals shortchange America. They've shortchanged jobs. They've driven up our trade deficit. We have, I think, close to a $12 billion, maybe it's 12 trillion. I get my numbers mixed up here, but it's a huge, each year we're running $500+ billion trade deficit. So yes, so let me correct that. I think since 1990 we have an excess, or since NAFTA went into effect in 1994, we have an excess of $11 trillion trade deficit, mostly with Japan, China, and Mexico. And that trade deficit means lower GDP, it means lower federal revenues, it means a higher federal debt, and we've got to attack that trade deficit. We got to rewrite these trade agreements, and we have to counter the world VAT system that greatly disadvantages American manufacturing.
You know, we've had presidential candidates, even in the last couple election cycles, say, if you manufacture in America, we're going to give you zero taxes for a little while to get your feet back on the ground. What say you on that?
Well, that was Mr. Santorum, but I would argue that we need to do more than just reduce taxes. It's not just the tax burden that's killing manufacturing. It's the trade deals that benefit these other countries. It's the currency manipulation going on by Japan, Mexico, and China that puts us at a huge disadvantage. And so we've got to find a way to change the globalist system that places us at the mercy of these global organizations and these other countries that don't give a whiff about the American worker.
Well, we'll continue on in that in that vein. What can we infuse back in the American spirit here to recapture this dream? What are some of your highest priorities?
In terms of simple things that would help bring manufacturing back and mm-hmm. bring jobs back is that we've got to ensure that everything made for the military, everything made for the Pentagon, everything made for the Air Force, for the Navy, for the Army, our supplies, our materials, our technology, our computers, our cell phones, our high-tech weapon stuff, all that stuff, all the parts of that needs to be made here in America by U.S. citizens for simply national security purposes. Why are we giving China a back door to the Pentagon? All our computers and cell phones are made in China. And is that just foolishness when you're talking about national security to give China backdoor to everything we do at the Pentagon? So I'm a follower of the great first Treasury Secretary Alexander Hamilton, that who insisted that we should have the capability of making all our national supply, especially for the military, and all those things need to be made by American prop, by American materials, American workers. And I'd also apply that to all infrastructure projects. That the SEPTA over there in Philadelphia, they buy their subway cars, and where are those subway cars made? They're made in Korea. And I would insist when we're using public dollars to build infrastructure, public dollars to build the military, all that stuff's got to be done here.
Well, and I would add to that quickly, the extra high voltage transformers in our grid, they're only made in South Korea and Germany right now.
Damage at the shore. There was a fire down in the shore last year that was caused by faulty transformers made somewhere else. They weren't made here. You're right on that. I agree with that.
How can our listeners hear more about and support your campaign? Can you give us a website?
Yeah, BobPattersonForCongress.com. Bob Patterson, two T's in Patterson. BobPattersonForCongress.com. My platform is laid out there. They can get involved. They can sign up for emails. They can contribute. But we are leading here in New Jersey with a very aggressive agenda, a very voter-specific agenda to bring back jobs, to secure the American dream, to keep America safe, and to protect the American worker. It's going to appeal to this is largely a Democratic district, but I think it has great... My agenda has great crossover appeal to both Republicans and Democrats.
And you are listening to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, WNJC 1360 AM, our flagship station in Philadelphia, and around the world on the Internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, Talk Stream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, and AM, FM, 24/7, theallinen.com. I'm Kevin Wade, J.D. Meniere's with me. We'll have our final guest in here in about 6 minutes and 30 seconds. You stay with us. We will be right back.
Playing the music on the Your Music Matters Morning Show. He is also an experienced mortgage loan officer working for U.S. Mortgage Corporation and assists homeowners navigate the reverse mortgage process. If you are finding yourself asking questions whether or not you set aside enough for retirement, Paul can sit down with you, your family, and your financial advisor and discuss how a reverse mortgage may be a valuable resource for your retirement plan. You will be responsible for paying your taxes and insurance, and the reverse mortgage can help with this and other expenses, such as home health care or other untimely bills. Put Paul's 20-plus years of experience to work for you, as choosing the right option for your situation can be critical. Call Paul at U.S. Mortgage Corporation at 877-213-9977. That's 877-213-9977. Or go to seniormatters.info for more information. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is a licensed mortgage banker in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Delaware, and an equal housing lender. NMLS number 3901. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is located at 201 Old Country Road, Suite 140, Melville, New York, 11747. This advertisement applies to first lien mortgages. Paul E. Dilks, NMLS, is 485904.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Biden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology? To be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCS for automation.com. That's PCS, the number four, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, ConservativeCommandosRadioNetwork.com and CCRN.com for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard.
I think we should make public colleges and universities tuition-free.
Climate change is directly related to the growth of terrorism.
Remove the federal prohibition on marijuana.
Climate change poses immediate risks to our national security.
I did not email any classified material to anyone. There is no classified material. Certainly well aware of the classification requirements.
We have a lot to learn from democratic socialist governments that have existed in countries like Denmark, Sweden, Finland, Norway.
This campaign is about a political revolution to transform this country.
You know?
Now more than ever, we need our voice in Washington. Now more than ever, we need Sharon Angle in Washington. Go to runsharonangle.com and help us draft Sharon Angle to run for U.S. Senate.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
If you'd like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our websites, www.ccrsnetwork.com and ccrshow.com. For mornings at 9 a.m., log on to Leading Edge Radio Network. At 1 p.m., log on to RoarRadio.net. And if you haven't had enough, at 9 p.m., log on to HighPlainsDailyNews.com. And you can listen to the Conservative Commandos from any telephone on the planet by calling 832-999-1199. We always kick off the first show of the week with the very best guests, and we're saving, I think, our best guest for last today. And J.D., his name is John Henry Weston. He's co-founder and editor-in-chief of LifeSiteNews.com. He's spoken at conferences around the world, as well as appearing on radio and television. And he founded Rome Life Forum, an annual strategy meeting for pro-life leaders worldwide. He's going to talk to us today about the U.N.'s rights chief seeming to exploit the Zika virus to promote abortion around the world. And with that, John Henry Weston, welcome to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show.
Thanks for having me. Great to be with you.
What is the UN doing?
Well, first of all, we have this situation where it started with pro-abortion organizations generally, but it's now the UN as well as the Pan American Health Organization are leaping on the claims about the Zika virus crisis to push for greater access to abortion, even and especially in pro-life South American countries. So you have the UN, which is following the lead of abortionists everywhere, urging Latin American countries, which, of course, they can't get into right now because abortion is illegal, and they're using the Zika virus to say that they must lift restrictions on abortion. And interestingly, it was the human rights chief of the UN himself, Zaid Raad al-Hussein is his name. And he said, and I'll quote it for you, he said, "Laws and policies that restrict women's access to these services, meaning abortion, must be urgently reviewed in line with human rights obligations in order to ensure the right to health for all in practice." I mean, and, you know, this is a joke. He's talking about the right to health for all, and what he's saying is they should eliminate babies in these areas. It is a real disgusting ploy to get abortion into those countries where they still defend the right to life.
What authority does the UN have in terms of speaking to people in any of these countries about this issue?
Exactly. It is supposed to be an organization that is protective of the sovereign rights of nations, yet we should know that for the past 40 years, the UN has been used as an agency which has pushed not only abortion, but also homosexual rights, etc., on countries unwilling to bend the knee, if you will, to this sort of, it's almost like a new world religion, for crying out loud, that you have to have abortion as a sacrament, that you have to have homosexual marriage, and so on and so forth. And this is being pushed through the United Nations onto countries which used to think they had sovereign rights.
But again, what authority do they have? I mean, aren't they just chattering in the distance?
Unfortunately, they have some. And the some authority comes this way. They will pass treaties at the United Nations, and usually the treaties are fought out between countries so that they have no pro-abortion language. However, they're interpreted by the treaty bodies, their examining bodies that go and talk to, or a country will send its representatives once every 5 years, those that have signed on to a particular treaty. And then a committee of the UN will talk to whatever government official is there and tell them about, you know, the following up of or the adhering to the various treaty. So if those committee members, as many have in the past, have interpreted the UN treaty to suggest legalization of abortion, which is false, but they have anyway, they then badger those countries to go ahead and live up to their treaty obligations. And so this has been done for 40 years in this way. And knowing that there are some politicians in those countries that do, you know, want for liberalization, so-called, of their laws, then they make hay with the UN recommendations for their countries. And so there is external pressure coming from the United Nations to legalize abortion in various countries.
And I imagine, and you can correct me on this, this isn't the first attempt they've tried to grab some momentary issue in order to advance their broader agenda.
Oh, absolutely not. Any time, I mean, it's just like petty politics anywhere. We've seen that politics has become a bit of a farce, unfortunately. You know, you see some horrific accident, and therefore, you know, you have to eliminate people being able to drink coffees in their car for everyone. This is the way politics is nowadays, and so this has been cottoned on to by the people pushing their agendas at the UN so that they take cases, and in this case, here's a perfect little storm. They see an outbreak of disease caused by, or seemingly caused by, mosquitoes, and the strangest part is the UN doesn't say, let's really try and eliminate mosquitoes. No, they're talking about eliminating unborn babies instead. I mean, the insanity there is mind-boggling. But the weird part is, they're not even sure about this association. between the Zika virus and this microcephaly, which is this problem that they say is related to it. And that's the really strange thing as well. So you have these, yes, there are cases of elevated cases in Brazil, especially, of microcephaly, which is this having a baby's having a small head, which is a disorder. And there is the Zika virus there as well. However, the Zika virus is in all sorts of other places where they don't have this microcephaly. So putting these two together is not, they're not causally related at all. This is someone's theory, and yet they're making the theory into fact, as if it were fact. So how then do we explain in other regions like Asia and Africa where the virus has appeared, there aren't these documented cases of microcephaly? In fact, the only confirmations that they actually do have of 404 confirmed cases of microcephaly in Brazil, only 17 of them tested positive for the virus at all.
So it hardly seems to be indicative of a cause and effect relationship.
That's what they seem to be saying, of course, but it's not there at all. This is someone's theory, not based on good evidence, and yet from this theory, which is tenuous at best, they are developing a program whereby they're telling all of these countries to go ahead and you have to legalize abortion now because of the great threat of the Zika virus.
Now, I do not know the long history of this UN commissioner and his commission. How long have they been looking to terminate life without giving it a chance to breathe its first breath of air as one of us on this world? How long have they been anti-life? Is this a new thing?
The UN commission, not this particular, it's not Zaid al-Hussein. It's been before him. The High Commissioner was Mary McAleese, who was the former Irish president, and she was extremely pro-abortion. And so it goes back a long ways now, right from the time of the various UN human rights groupings. We're talking now 25, 30 years. They've already been pushing the anti-life agenda, and it's very difficult for pro-life countries to maintain their stance for respect for all human life when they're getting pressure from they're getting pressure from the United States, from all of Europe, they're getting pressure from the UN, and even within their own countries, they've got liberal agitators fomenting this stuff. So with all the whole world bearing down on them, it is extremely difficult to uphold the right to life for all unborn children. And yet it is so vital to them, they do that. But this is has been a really big club with which to beat down the opposition for pro-abortion folks internationally.
Could I ask you to stay with us through this upcoming break? Because we're right there right now, and we'll pick up our discussion on the other side in about 3 minutes.
Happy to.
We're on the phone with John Henry West, and co-founder and editor-in-chief of LifeSite News. He's going to stay with us. You stay with us as well. We're coming to you live from the Conservative Commandos Radio Network studios, WNJC 1360 AM, our flagship station in Philadelphia. And around the world on the internet with American Patriots, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, and AMFM 24/7, theallondon.com. I'm Kevin Wade. J.D. Manier is in the house today. We will be right back in about 3 minutes and 45 seconds.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2
to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSnetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Vidin of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
I think we should make public colleges and universities tuition free.
Climate change is directly related to the growth of terrorism.
Remove the federal prohibition on marijuana.
Climate change poses immediate risks to our national security.
I did not email any classified material to anyone. There is no classified material. Certainly well aware of the classification requirements.
We have a lot to learn from democratic socialist governments that have existed in countries like Denmark, Sweden, Finland, Norway.
This campaign is about a political revolution to transform this country.
Now more than ever, we need our voice in Washington. Now more than ever, we need Sharon Angle in Washington. Go to runsharonangle.com and help us draft Sharon Angle to run for U.S. Senate.
You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Hey, thanks for staying with us. You are listening to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show. If you'd like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our website, ccrsnetwork.com and ccrshow.com. Or mornings at 9 a.m., log on to Leading Edge Radio Network. Or at 1 p.m., log on to RoarRadio.net. And if you haven't had enough, folks, at 9 p.m., log on to HighPlainsDailyNews.com. And you can listen to the Conservative Commandos from any telephone on the planet by simply dialing or pushing the buttons. 832-999-1199. I'm Kevin Wade. It's Monday, 7th of March. I'm in the studio with J.D. Manier, who's blessed me by sharing the co-host duties today. And on the phone with us is John Henry Weston, co-founder and editor-in-chief of LifeSiteNews.com. And we're talking about, the United Nations trying to influence decisions internal to a nation to also encourage abortion using the appearance of the Zika virus as the reason. Thank you for staying with us.
Great being here.
How many other people are aware of the UN's I'll call this a distortion in reaching out to people around the world about the Zika virus?
And that's just the thing. Not many. It's very difficult when all of the mainstream media, which carries most of our information, is carrying the same false line. Thankfully, there are a few voices have pierced the mainstream media bubble. And that's why I thank God for Conservative Commando Radio and for LifeSite News, trying to bring the truth out when the mainstream media just won't have it. But there were a few voices that did voice their concerns and broke the mainstream media bubble. That's because they had some clout in the countries. The Catholic bishops, both of Brazil and other places which have been doing this, said how terribly wrong this was and how it was unconscionable for the United Nations, of all places, to suggest they legalize baby killing. So at least there's some voices that have been heard to say that this is absolutely wrong. But the facts of the fact of the matter is, most people don't know. Most people hear, a trumped up version of this outbreak, and they're deathly afraid of it. And with that comes the need, so-called need, to offer abortion to poor women. Therefore, abortion must be legalized. Otherwise, these countries are just totally unfeeling and unfit. And so
my co-host, J.D. Manier, has a question for you.
Well, a question and comment. And, this comes right on the heels of the U.N. sex crimes, 69 allegations, 23 with minors, with the people involved in peacekeeping operations. So, comment on that. I mean, they have a checkered past, and now they're promoting abortions all over the planet.
The very strange part is that, of course, the United Nations itself comes from dealing with the horrors of extermination of people. It is born out of the horrors of the Second World War, of Nazism. And the cry at the time was never again. That's why it was developed. It was developed to stop the atrocities against human life. That's why you have the UN Charter of Human Rights that is supposed to protect, as they say, all human rights. It's supposed to guarantee, and I quote, the inherent right to life of every human being. And they say in the charter, every human being, the inherent right to life. It is incredible that this organization that's founded on this very document has been co-opted to such an extent that they are pushing against the inherent right to life of every human being, and they're pushing for abortion. It's absolutely unbelievable. Such that it is not surprising at all that they're guilty of all sorts of abuses, including the abuses that you've just mentioned.
Well, I've got probably one more question, and this is about the pro-life movement, which you strongly support. Why can't we get moderators in these Democrat debates to bring up the abortion and abortion on demand?
And that is because it's all about polling. This is polling and messaging for these guys. It is, they know they have a losing battle when it comes to people and abortion, and particularly young people today and abortion. Because they did their polling, and the polling results come back, and they will tell you a few very interesting things. Number one, they will tell you that the whole partial birth abortion thing was a total loser for the abortion movement. Everybody could recognize they're killing kids there, and it is totally gruesome. They bring out the baby. They kill the baby when it's sort of partially out. It was first of all, it's disgusting, and it's an absolute nightmare that it goes on in America, and yet it does. But they knew that was a loser, so they will not bring it up in under any circumstances. And then another point that's a loser for them, and difficult for them to understand why they're losing people, but one of the reasons why also is that many of the younger set of people who are alive today have ultrasound pictures of themselves. And if you have an ultrasound picture of yourself, you realize, oh my gosh, there must be something wrong with abortion. It's not just a blob of tissue, because look, there's me some 30 years ago. And so, it's no surprise to me at all that debate moderators, they won't even allow debate on the issue, because they will lose, and they know it.
John Henry Weston, tell our audience how to stay current with your important work and how to get involved.
LifeSiteNews.com is a daily news service covering the issues of life, faith, family, and freedom from around the world. We have 26 on staff. We have reporters literally all over the globe. We have a big staff in the United States, in Canada, in New Zealand, Australia. In Rome, we're just getting our new reporter in Rome because ours just left us last year. And we have in Paris, France, all over the world, we have reporters reporting from on the ground, talking to the best experts in the world about what's going on all of these very intricate issues. There's enough news there, usually between 15 and 25 stories a day, every day, for everyone's interest. And if you want to stay current on the issues, please keep up with LifeSiteNews.com. We have a search engine there that goes right back to our founding nearly 20 years ago now in 1997, so you can track all of these issues as well at LifeSite News.
John Henry Weston, excuse me, thank you so much for being with us today, and you keep up the good fight, my brother.
Thank you so much, and God bless you all.
God bless you. JD, great show.
I think these guests who came on, boy, it was tremendous, Kevin, working with you again. Ben Collins, decorated Marine Green Beret, and we had Bob Patterson, candidate for U.S. House Rep here in New Jersey, and it's great guest, John Henry Weston.
And Christina, thank you so much for your reflections on Nancy Reagan. We miss her, and you had the blessing of actually meeting her and being around her.
Yes, it was a privilege. Thanks for letting me share that today.
And thanks for being with us. Hey, it's another show in the can. If your computer locks up this afternoon, contact the NSA tomorrow. They'll have a copy of the show they can send you. I'm Kevin Wade. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show. God bless, Godspeed, and may God save the United States of America.